Hello and welcome to India and New Delhi for the ISSF World Cup Finals 2017. 50-meter rifle, three positions for men is the event we're going to look at and talk you through in the next hour or so. Welcome to wherever you are in the planet. Today, my special guest is a top shooter. On her day, she blows away the opposition. She's looking at the camera now. Stetsana Pejcik from Croatia. How are you?
Good. Hi. Good morning, afternoon. I don't know.
It changes in Europe. The actual hour went back last night as well. So Jamie's going to introduce the athletes. Van Penny won the 10 meter 2 days ago. He's really on fire. So another 20-year-old athlete. It's two in a row. I'm not going to mention his age, but he's won his first junior gold medal 26 years ago.
That's my guy.
That's my guy. You're quite a small team, aren't you?
Sorry?
You're quite a small team.
Yeah.
Two finals in the World Cups this season, so coming into form, ranked number 10. As Jamie said, world number 4. Julie, always present.
It's amazing to have her for a coach.
Former, was it 2004 Olympic champion?
And 8th in air and smallball.
Lexi Raymer took his debut victory in Munich a couple of months ago. So Philip, 18 years old. He looks young, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's the youngest, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, just by 2 years. Yeah, great job. This will be his last responsibility today, I believe. 8 athletes. 3 different techniques. So Jana's going to tell us all about them, how complex they are. I'm going to summarize. We got kneeling first of all. There's Damir Rulatin and Laura Giugietta. So all the champions are still here.
Yeah.
Great. The kneeling, as far as I understand, it is very difficult to work out, but once you work it out, it's quite stable.
Yeah, I think technically is the most challenging position, at least it's for me. I struggled through years and years with everything in kneeling. But once when you get it, it's there, and it's just like, oh, this is easy.
Well, we'll see. So yesterday the scores in the kneeling were a little bit higher than the standing, not quite as high as the prone, and I guess that's the norm, isn't it?
Actually, yes. Most of the time it's like that. But you know, you always have some crazy results. For example, Istvan today in standing, it's just 3.96. It's amazing.
He really shot to, I don't know, fame, but a couple of years ago on my debut in Thailand. Mm-hmm. And he talked to the audience. A few minutes later, he shot. He won a medal, and it was like, okay, I'm only, he was 18 at the time.
Yeah.
But he's so mature. But
yeah, he's an amazing guy.
You can actually approach him as well. Let's hope Philip doesn't get caught in the fog lights. He looks like it's his first major event. Although he has medalled in the juniors.
Yeah, he's obviously has, I really think, even in the seniors.
In the World Cups. So junior, he took silver in Seoul this year.
Oh, that's, I think, was that then European Championships or something?
Europeans, he won the juniors in Baku.
Oh, okay.
Or maybe senior. Junior.
I would bet that he won something in air rifle, like a medal at the World Cup in Baku. Maybe I'm mistaken.
Athletes of your level are never mistaken.
Ah, yes.
Gold
Damn,
in 2016. Alexei, let's see how he comes through. Had some good results this season.
Yeah.
One in Munich, which is the three World Cups. I suppose it's the most intense, isn't it?
It is. It's the results are the highest there, definitely. It's I don't know what it is. Is it the water there or the air? But the results are always really high. It's hard to get to the finals.
And Stefan, how do you keep motivated for won his first medal, gold medal 26 years ago? I suppose if it's your passion, it's fairly easy.
I bet it is. You know, the passion, the love for sports. And when you're doing good, kind of winning medals becomes you become addictive to it. It's nice, you know, go to the podiums, winning stuff.
You won the silver yesterday. Won the silver.
Yeah.
Were you happy with that?
Yes, I am. You know, you always hope for the, you know, to win, to be the best, but actually I'm really quite happy with it.
Jolin was on form, wasn't she?
She was amazing.
Jolin Bier won the gold medal yesterday for Germany.
Especially last five shots, they were really wow. Well deserved.
So today we're going to have three series of five in each position, 7 minute changeover, then prone, same three series of five. And so far, I was going on about this chap looks young and nervous, but he's not doing too badly, is it?
No.
Lebajal from the Czech Republic, 52.8, but
that's
crucially,
really good.
Is whole 0.9 ahead of Penny in second position.
It's still early, but nevertheless, 52.8, I would take it anytime. Also, his kneeling in qualifications was amazing.
So what we saw yesterday with the women, and there was a direct reference, is that the second and third series were better, so they actually settled into the rhythm.
Yeah, I guess it depends, but kind of, for me at least, the first one is always you're more nervous, and then you kind of, I wouldn't say relax, but breathe more comfortably.
Well, for you, from my memory, you were 50.3, 51.6, 52.3.
Yeah, too bad there wasn't a fourth series.
It's a 10.8.
Yeah, that's a good one. They're all shooting good.
So this is, how do you, we noticed some athletes, like Stine Nielsen, she always leaves the last second to shoot.
Yeah.
Is that because she had a technical problem, or that's just the way she does it to annoy everyone else?
It's her way. We were joking, me and her coach, yesterday, that she gives him gray hair every time. But it's, I guess it worked for her.
To the qualifications,
slower.
She left it the last 3 minutes, really?
No, actually minute and a half.
Okay.
Yeah. It's stressful. But it's her way.
Stevan Penny, apart from the fact that he's figured out something, what makes him so good? His personality, his technique, his support team, or just everything?
I would say his mental state. I think that he's one of the mentally strongest shooters. It's, you know, some, not only in shooting, but in every sport, you have those people, they just have that something. I think Istvan has that something. You can't put a finger on it, it's just, it's there for him.
I do sports commentating in other events, and I think you're correct there. Is there are certain star athletes who don't see themselves as stars that you can almost see them calculating things.
Yeah.
And just everything. So it's, okay, I have to go for my massage now, I need to go for a training session here, do I have time to fit it in? And mm-hmm. you can see the brain working at a million kilometers an hour.
Yeah.
And I have the impression that, speaking to Istvan, I spoke to him a few days ago when he just arrived, and I said, okay, I see you've got a day off here. Would you want to do some commentating? And he was like, calculation. No, thank you, because.
Mm-hmm.
Which is great.
Yeah.
Same like yourself. I'd never talked to you about business before your mm-hmm. event. There's some athletes that like it and others that don't. Philip still has
a good
lead now. 52.1, so he's 104.9 ahead of Bartnik, who's 103.2. Penny's been consistent with a 51.9 and a 50. Well, you could see the results yourself. At the moment, the gap at the bottom is still fairly narrow. It's 0.3, with Liu and Hui, the two Chinese athletes at the moment, slow to ramp up the pace.
And that's a strange thing to see, I think. You know, Chinese at the bottom of the...
If a European athlete wanted to go and spend some time with the Chinese system, would it be a value, or is it the fact that they just have such a massive pyramid to start with that they just have for some reason? If you have a million athletes doing something, some are more talented. Can you train their system?
I have no idea, actually.
That's the best question I've ever asked. 20 seconds and
I
you said no.
I think a part of Nico Campriani and Petr Vlazing, I don't know if anyone else ever went to train with Chinese team.
Seems to work for him.
Yeah, I think he's, how should I put it?
Smiling all the time.
Really special man. You know, before I was talking about having that something, he has it in spades. So I don't think that, yeah, he's something else.
Someone's looking to fill the gap, and at the moment, Tomasz Bartnik's not doing a bad job. He had 51.3, 51.9, and so far he's 30.5 after the first three shots. This is only, it's only going to be near 2 minutes, then it's change over time.
Philip has two nines, but it's still early. And Alexis started really, really good.
If you look at the, you can only just see pretty much one dot. It's
yeah. That's a nice group.
The music's fairly sort of escalator, shopping centre music today. So you really can't, it doesn't really mean anything. It's not that you can't really dance to it, can you?
Yeah, the music is weird, actually. The whole competition is weird.
They play great music about an hour before. And then suddenly for the final it all goes a bit...
Yeah, something happens.
A bit wet.
I don't know who's the DJ, but...
Need to have a word for next time.
Yeah.
Alex, you know.
He's holding up great.
He has, he's coming through, hasn't he? It's consistent,
yeah.
51 flat, 51.1.
I think that's the most important thing, just to be consistent and try not to get nervous if things don't work out immediately.
Now, could you, I asked this question yesterday and the athlete agreed with me. When you're on form, so you just, it just for some way, you just feel like you're firing at a dinner plate and everything's going in. Can you keep that confidence going for the next stage? Or is it three separate?
I think I'm the wrong person for you to ask that, because I never do that. Even if I'm really on top of my game, really in form, I don't go really confident about anything in shooting, because then it's game over for me.
So it's mechanical with you?
With me, it's really like focus on the technical things and should be fine. Anything else, it creates a big problem for me.
Well, we're looking at Alexei Raymond, because he's just scored a 53.1, which quite
really
rightly
good.
So puts him in the top of 155.2, which is 0.8 ahead of Stevan Penny, who's worrying for the others, moving up the scoreboard.
That's a really good result. But it's still early, like you said. It's 45 shots, so...
So, as we know, it's now the famous 7 minutes. Are you conscious of what Jamie, who's trying to have
yes.
some sort of reaction from the audience, are you conscious that he's dying on stage, or
yeah,
are you listening and saying, come on, Jamie?
Yesterday I was listening. Most of the time I hear, but sometimes, like, it's going to sound stupid, but sometimes I even understand what he's saying. Not
no one else does, it's amazing.
No, just... like, I really start to thinking about what he's saying. Sometimes you can hear, but you don't hear, really.
I know, because he does quizzes and stuff.
Yeah,
amazing
and
quizzes.
Yesterday I was thinking when he was talking about the colors being on the ISSF logo, and he said, I think, that either white or black is not the color. I'm thinking, hey, wait, no. Either both are not colors or both are colors. And I think, what are you doing? Come on, focus. So, yeah, sometimes it's more disturbing than some other times. Depends. I wasn't really that focused yesterday in that change over time.
Is it because this is the end of the season celebration of all that's good about the sport, in the sense that you have the top 12 athletes here and the top 8 in the final? Does it mean it's more relaxed?
No. I think for me, I look at this as a beginning of the season, because I made my pause after European Championships. That was in, I think, beginning of July. And now, you know, you start to train, although we start with air. And this is just yes, it's the end of the small ball season, but when I get home, 3 days later, I have my first competition in air, so kind
and
of...
Wow, so it's keeping gay,
yeah,
keeping gay.
Yeah, and I didn't touch air since World Cup Munich, so it's going to be fun.
So my theory that when you first shot your great prone competition, you'd forgotten to bring your mat, and you decided that works for you.
Oh, I didn't. Yesterday?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't forget.
No, I was saying a long time ago when you first did it, and that's why you decided forever after not to have a map.
I've never forgotten. No, I consciously didn't. I don't use it. Rarely I use it, because, well... Actually, it's stupid. It takes you a couple of seconds to put it, and I'm thinking, yeah, I don't need it. But yesterday was funny, because I lie down, and I was thinking, oh, I don't need the mat, it's fine. And I lay down, and my right elbow just start to slide away. I'm thinking, ooh, maybe that was a mistake.
Okay.
But I kind of persuade myself that the elbow will stay in place. So it was. It did.
And so from then on?
Sometimes I have more luck than brains.
So the athletes, Jamie's doing his best to annoy the athletes.
yeah, nicely put. I'm glad that it wasn't me who said it.
There's John, who does quite a lot of the camera work. He also edits the highlight package, which I'm halfway through voicing. He'll be voicing later tonight. And yes.
And you know, it's not easy what he does.
He's unique. He's absolutely unique. I mean,
I'm always thinking, how do you know what to say in 9 minutes or 7? It's not a lot of time, but then again, if you have to do it, do that, it's an hour.
Yeah, but James does a lot of radio and a lot of stuff in the UK, so he's used to talking to himself, essentially. There are like millions of people watching, but he's used to talking to himself, so it's a great skill.
It makes sense, yeah.
Anyway, the athletes are now involved in their sighting shots. If you just tuned in, you are a third of the way through the final of the World Cup final. And it is the three positions for the men. Snjana Pejcic from Croatia.
You sound like me.
Happily joined us today. She came second yesterday in the 3P, which gave us a lot of fun. And as you can see on the graphics, it's changeover and sighting time. The changeover has been done. The last sighting, they'll be mechanically doing what now, apart from the obvious?
Well, they're trying to set into a position. You always, you know, in your qualifications, you have, of course, more time to settle in the position. And especially, you know, prone and standing, there is no limit for the sighter, so you can get up, get down. In finals, that's the limitation because you have limited time and there is not really a lot of, you know, place to wiggle. You don't really have time to get up and down maybe more than once, if even that. So I think important thing is just to be able to go into your position or really close to it from the beginning.
And give yourself
plenty
of time.
And try to take your pulse down.
And apparently you're quite good at that sort of thing. Mechanically, what can you do? What's your record? Can you take it down from... How high is it, sorry, when you've had the adrenaline of the kneeling? You've had obviously the physical exertion of changing your kit.
So I was able to measure it once at the World Cup in Munich. Although it was in standing, it was 130.
Okay, so that's equivalent of having done a 5-mile jog.
Yeah, it's difficult. I have a feeling like my heart is in my throat and looking way to get out.
But that's the skill, isn't it? Being able to control what you can do every day whilst under extreme pressure. If you look at some of the flags, they're starting to wave a bit in the middle. Does that come into play or not really?
This is okay. That's nothing actually. More important are the flags in front. But all in all, it's quite calm range. Even for the qualifications, there was just a little bit of wind, but just for a few seconds.
Do you adjust that for your first couple of shots?
I actually shade. If it's a windy range, windy day, I shade. I don't, like we say, click. But it's personal preferences.
So we're moving into the first series of 5 shots for the prone position, where they have slightly less time.
I almost said, and the results should be a bit higher, but then I looked at Alex's third series with 53.1. I'm thinking, maybe not.
If he does higher, he's certainly going to be on a good form day. We had Xing Minye yesterday, who did a 53.5.
In prone?
Yeah.
No.
Sorry?
Yeah, that's nice.
That's an average of, what, 10.7?
It looks easy when somebody else does it.
Well, let's see. 10.6, 10.1.
It started with a 9.
That's good for Alexei. He's obviously listening to what you're saying. He said, I'm going to show her I can do better.
Yeah. Challenge accepted.
Alexei Raymond in your picture.
It's 10.9 from Istvan.
10.8, 10.9. So, you've done most jobs in this sport in the sense that you've been around quite a while. Do you have a future in World Cup coaching, you think, eventually? Doesn't seem to be much fun. You sit there and you can do absolutely nothing about it.
Yeah. I don't know. I would like to stay in shooting. I'm not quite decided what to do exactly, but why not? I think I have some knowledge, and it would be nice to
pass it on to the next generation.
Yeah, exactly.
So let's see who's
doing. Oh my god, this is great. He really took up the challenge.
Patrick just had a 9.9. Raymond's a 10.6.
That group is crazy.
Who's?
Alexis, sorry.
They're all pretty much. You don't need the rest to score, would you?
Yeah.
So, 5 shots. This is the first series of the print. Let's see what they can do at the moment.
Oh.
Liu Yukan from China, 52.1. Philip Nipajel, 52.2. He did take your challenge on.
Yes, yes.
So, great scoring.
Well played.
53.2 from Alexis Raymond. Raymond, sorry.
That's a quite big mistake for Hui with 9.1, his last shot.
So series 4, there's going to be 2 more identical series than a changeover. But Alexis Raymond has a lead of 2.1.
That's a decent lead.
Clearly, when you started the competition, all athletes started on level playing field, level pegging rather, so they started from 0. However, you take the scores forward clearly for the 3 challenges you have here. Tell me about Petar. Personality-wise, he's suited for this? I guess he is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He's, we talked before, Milutin and me, he's a really technical-oriented guy, Petar is. And the way his brain works, it's amazing.
In what sense?
I think he's all, you know, all the calculations and everything. For example, he does part of his rifle for himself, the palm rest, cheek piece.
He makes it himself?
Yes. And let's say I would never in a million years be able to do that. But he's like, oh yeah, yeah, I know what to do. I need to do this because of this, and this will affect this in this way. And I'm like, okay. So it's stunning to just, you know, listen to him.
It's working. So far, he's number, well, 4th position. Let me see, any big scored. Stevan from Serbia came up with a 10.8.
Yeah, this group looks much better for him.
So we're going to have eliminations, not after the next series, in 15 shots time. Alexis Raymond is continuing to find form, not quite as high as before, but still.
51.9, it's okay.
52.7, Petar Gorsa from Croatia is just beaten by Stevan Pletikosic from Serbia.
It's so interesting, you know, to see you shooting 15 in kneeling, 15 in prone, but at the end of the day, everything just, you're just waiting for that standing where everything is, you know, developing actually.
So that's where you can certainly lose the series in this, but you can't really win it.
Yes.
There's a question that's a dumb question. Serbia doesn't have a massive population, but they're very good at every discipline.
Yeah, amazing, right?
I mean, just if you look at it around the dinner table, it's like last night I walked past and they all have big smiles on their faces because they've all done incredibly well.
They're all amazing people.
But there's 4 or 5, isn't there? Really, there's Andriy had won, there's Damir had won, Militin was close, there's who else is there? There's Zorana, she got a medal, and they're all sort of, and then we've got Stevan now, so pretty much all the team.
Yeah, they're really insanely good.
Do you know why? Obviously, you're quite close.
I think it's as we are individual sport, that's how we roll. It's the individual in them. They have all of them, they have different personalities.
You don't want two Zoranas, do you?
No. Oh, no.
Anyway, just break off briefly to talk about the what we have in hand. Alexei Ermond was absolutely scintillating about this. The two guys, Besigay and Kukakinuk, who were in the... One was in the final, one missed out a few minutes ago in the 25-metre rapid fire. So it's great they come to support Alexei, who they're actually chatting to just afterwards. Philip is second place, so he's been pretty much under the radar, but
this
he's been performing
nice
very, very well.
So far for him, the first three shots, really good.
Stevan Penn is the dangerous one because he is the man on form at the moment in the standing position. Sorry, briefly, so Serbia, so you don't want too many personalities the same, but they have a wonderful mix that works.
Yeah, I think so. And they have, you know, every one of them, they have their path and they're committed to it and they're doing stuff their way. And I think it works for them.
Inspires the whole generation of great shooters. Here we go, this almost finished the third series now. So Petar Gorsa is moving up the scoreboard. Tomasz Bartnik, both had 51.6, is staying pretty much where he is. Liu Yukan, he's trying to save his skin with a 52.1. 52.2 from Philippe Nebuchel and Alexis Raymond, it's compared to his amazingly high standards, he's given back some of his lead. So his lead now is down to 0.7 with Esteban Penny a little bit back, 0.9 further off. But those are the three medal positions. Well, you can see exactly what's happening here.
It's close. It's still really close, especially coming standing where anything can happen.
And say these athletes, or you, are you thinking, oh no, I can't mess up this next section?
I can't mess it up. Just trying not to panic, I guess.
Talking about panicking, what happened to Nadine yesterday? Because she was doing well from from Austria. She's watching us. She's watching there. She was in the standing position yesterday. It just fell apart.
It happens.
Okay.
I don't know. I didn't ask if anything happened or just, you know, wasn't her day in standing. It's... Especially she's quite young. It's her first World Cup final. And you come here and you're thinking, maybe, I don't know, maybe she didn't. But I know I was thinking, oh, it's nine of us. God, I hope I won't be the ninth.
Okay, yeah.
So that's like additional little bit of pressure. For example, men, there were just eight of them. It's a kind of easier.
All of you through, yeah.
Yeah, but okay.
Is it lonely in the qualifying hall? Because normally there's 70 or 80 of you, and there's lots of noise and hundreds of picks. And there's just a little group in the middle. That just
Like, oh, just a couple of us came to train a bit.
Okay. Serious competition. They were rather smart boots.
Yeah.
So they have 9 minutes. It takes about 2 minutes to do his boots up.
Oh, it goes fast once you're trained to do it.
Have you ever calculated how many parts you have to change?
Actually, no. I go just systematically from the top of my rifle to the bottom.
And do you practice this at home?
Maybe
you
I
put
should
the stuff
say
on your
yes,
sofa
but actually no. I never train finals or changeover. And I think I'm, if not first, in first three that do the changeover.
It's just something that works for you. You've figured out how to.
Yeah, exactly. I think so, yes. At the beginning, it was quite hard because when I would go to standing, I was always thinking, oh, there's no time. And I came up, stand, and just breathing really hard. And you can't shoot like that. Now, just I figured out there is always enough time.
Experience, I guess.
Yeah. Like in everything in life. Comes in handy.
Put your glasses on, prepare. I think that's the thing in any sport. You know, if you've done it 100 times, you know not to panic and you know to trust yourself.
Yes. You know how to control yourself. sometimes you can, sometimes it's harder, but at the end of the day, you know, people that come to World Cup final, they know what to do.
Do you ever get annoyed by your body because you think, oh no, you've let me down again? Like if you have two bottles of wine. I'm not saying, but that, you know that that's how I would equate to it. Sometimes your body doesn't do what you want it to do.
Yes, actually, for me it happens. It happened quite some time. Like something is happening, and I have no idea what. Some tremor, and where does it come from? And is this my leg? No, give me back my foot and stuff like that. But yeah, it's all part of the game.
I think you have to remember it's the same for everyone.
Yeah,
it's all 8 competitors at breathing and.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think anyone comes here and they just, oh, sure, I got this, and just call as a cucumber, just, you know, go through the finals and wins. I don't think it happens that way. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe somebody...
there's Andrea, obviously passionate about watching the changeover.
Yeah, that's the most interesting part in shooting.
I suppose for people who don't know it, it's like, oh, look at that, look at that, look at that. But those of you who've seen it 1,000 times, it's like...
I think most of the people who don't know it thinking, what the hell is this? What are they doing? Why they don't shoot? I think it's quite confusing for people outside of shooting. At least I've heard that they're not really... It's not easy to follow.
From an outsider, I think they've got some really jazzy colours. How does Alexei, he's gone for the Czech national colours?
I suppose. Czech?
Well,
why?
Similar to French, I suppose.
Yeah, and that's not red.
Well, the Czechs have a little triangle, don't they?
In the yeah,
middle.
Yeah.
So I mean.
Oh, you mean the position of it? Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. But they're amazing colours.
Yeah, some shooters take the colours of the national team. Some just take the colours that they like.
And some just buy the cheapest, I guess.
Yeah.
There's Jamie. Question time. I wonder if he's using the same questions as last time he said he was going to.
But he's giving pen away.
Oh, yeah, it must be worth at least
pen, yeah.
15 centimes. The athletes are trying to, they're looking at Jamie and think, what's he going on about now? But they're trying to concentrate on their breathing, I guess, if you look at the actions.
Yeah.
Standing in line.
Breathing is really important. You just...
So if you have a cold, does that really mess up the whole system?
Well, it doesn't help. But then again, I guess you work through it, you do your best and... hope for the best. You can influence on some things. So.
Alexis Raymond from France is leading by 0.7 from Philippe Nebuchel from Czech Republic. That's what I was talking about. If you look at the flag, it's talking about the triangle.
Yeah, yeah.
Hungary has Stevan Penny, who won 2 days ago the 10 meter. Croatia, Petar Gorsa, is in fourth place, half a point back, or half a whole number, 5 points back. Then it's Poland, Tomasz Bartnik, China, Liu Yukin, is 2.5 points back, so that's where the gap starts to form. Half a point back from Serbia, Stefan Pekitovic. And at the moment, it's 1.5 points off the pace, Hui Zicheng. So there's quite a big gap now. There's 8 points between first and eighth.
You were good at math at school, right?
I used to trade foreign exchange, so...
Actually, we don't see the differences on the screen, and I'm really bad at math. And here you are.
Good, everyone to their own.
Yep.
There's Nasina, I was talking about it.
I remember once Raymond de Bevets told me in the old system finals that he was able to follow all 8 shooters, their results, on decimal.
He needs to get a life.
That's for me, that's just, wow. I can't follow mine.
You know, but to be fair, you're you look normal, but you are exceptional individuals. You have perfected an art.
I look normal, really. Are you sure?
Okay, you don't, but most athletes look normal. And but we did notice your hair's growing longer, isn't it?
I said that I hit the middle age crisis and did decide to go for it.
But on a serious note, you are normal people doing exceptional things and do the best in the world. So although you're friendly and chatting, you are the best in the world. So the fact that you have great memories, probably above average intelligence, multilingual, is that's the norm here.
I guess. I don't know. I've never looked at it that way.
That's because you're inside.
Maybe. It's like you have this bunch of people around me who are doing just as good as I am or better. You know, it depends on the day. Sometimes you win, sometimes you're second or seventh. Doesn't matter. But anyone, you know, whoever ends up eighth here is not a bad shooter. It's just this day. Today wasn't really his day because, like I said, nobody qualifies for the World Cup final by accident.
So how does it work now? We start eliminating athletes quite soon.
Yeah. Now the fun begins.
And can you use that word? When you're out there yourself?
Fun?
Would you say I'm having fun?
Never. Okay. Well, at some point, of course, yes.
Once you win.
You know, I don't remember having that much fun as I had last shot yesterday. Because I think even on camera you can see me smiling, and I never do that. I'm all this that serious face.
And what could we put that down to?
But it was so nice because I knew that Julien has it. And, you know, it's not like, okay, I quit, I don't, you know. You always give your best, but it kind of was, oh my God, I won silver. I'm so happy. So, yeah, sometimes, yeah, you have fun. But mostly I think I'm too nervous to have fun, to remember to have fun.
So, Alexei Reynaud at the moment is leading, has a 0.7 lead.
That is, I think, 10.6. That's a nice start.
Mr. Ben. Penny only had a 9.8.
That's a good shot. You know, nines that are in, it's okay. Bartnik with 10.8.
So Liu is having challenges at the bottom.
Yes, 8.2.
But in fact, the both athletes in the People's Republic of China are struggling today.
Apart from him, this is a really good start for standing.
There's Istvan Penny in your picture. He does the Bundesliga, I believe.
Yeah. Istvan was shooting amazing qualification. He actually equaled the world junior record. And I think four shots before the end, he had a new world record. Well, he had to shoot four tens, if I'm not mistaken, but
there's Philip in the picture.
Had 10.9.
Who saw that?
Philip.
That's why we're probably watching him. So at the moment he's second. And follows it by,
you know, when I see, oh, he's 18, and when I see him shooting like this, or I can't remember her name, but the Iranian girl in air rifle.
When I told you that, you said, what's happened? And I said, she's only 50, you nearly dropped your sandwich.
Yes, it's just...
It's not fair.
It's not fair, exactly, thank you, it's not
fair. She topped qualification with an amazing score.
It's crazy. When I see them doing that, and I'm thinking, what are you doing here, old lady? Alexis has also...
You could keep going another 30 years, but here...
Well...
It's possible.
Well...
No, it is possible. So, Tomasz Bartnik is shooting faster than the others. A 10.7 from Stefan Pletikosic.
No, 8.9.
That's a shot before, I guess.
Yeah.
That's why he's looking a bit
concerned.
Oh,
yeah, your screen is... later than my screen.
It's better. Before it wasn't working this morning. So we do have the best view in the house though. We're just to the right of the athletes. All our technical support.
Yeah, from here, I always think that they can see us and they're looking at us. But actually, when you're there, I didn't see you, your table, when I was shooting.
I thought you were just being rude.
No, it's just me. This is really good, really good scores.
So it's really close at the top with Alexei Uemor and Philippe Nabuchel, both scoring a 51.2. And it does mean that still Alexei has a 0.7 lead. Stevan Penny, well, he's dropped back. He's 1.5 off the pace with Bartik having some good scores coming up the line. And Lou is having a battle with Pletikosic from Serbia. There's a 0.5 between the two. Zorana's just coming up to give you a message. It's all about, is there a pistol available for your competition that starts
exactly.
soon?
Exactly.
Has she found a pistol?
She found a pistol, and when we're finished, I need to go and check if I can shoot something with
just
it.
Just explain briefly why, so you did, you've gone mad. There's a champion's trophy this afternoon. You didn't bring your air rifle, so you decided to have a go at pistol. You need to find a pistol, but you have small hands, so you couldn't borrow a man, so you didn't have time to go and try on because you're here. So Zorana was sent to go and fetch one, and she's found one.
Perfect.
Here we go, back to 9.6 from Bartnik, 10.4 from Liu, and they're fairly well group to the bottom.
10.6 from Petar. That's great.
Stevan is sucking his 9.8. We predicted he's great things, but he's has to make a move in a minute. He's
Alex is 9.3.
Petar Gorsa, your compatriot, and 10.6. Say he's safe in fourth position. So when do we start losing our first athletes?
After this series, the seventh and the eighth one goes out.
At the moment it's Hui and Liu, but very close. It's switching every shot, in fact.
This is irritating. I'm looking at Bartnik's target, and it's like nines, really good nines, but all over the ten, you know, just going around.
So that tells you?
No, it just makes me like, come on, go one, go in.
All around is needs to put in the center.
Yeah.
Well, it's a 10.3. It's getting a bit closer.
10.9 for Istvan.
Well, he needed that because that was at the bottom. It's going to be really close, but they need to come out of the top seventh and eighth place. At the top, it's still Alexei Raymond who's leading. There's Penny. Been doing a 10.9 was his last shot. I suppose that's not too bad.
10.8 for Bartnik.
But there's quite a big gap to make up from first to third.
Yeah.
And like you predicted, there's anything could happen in the final standings. Is this where nerves come into it most? I suppose because it's the least stable position.
I think so. And it's the end, and you know that it's like, it's now. You don't have a time for
to make it up. Like you can't do it tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. And you can't make it up in the next position because this is it.
So it's all fairly logical, really.
Yeah.
There's the detailed scores of the positions. Be nice if they kept that up all the time, to be fair. So you can keep, well, we could nice to see some shots occasionally.
Oh, Steva has nice five shots, 52.1, that's really nice.
So, Serbia wants to stay in, it depends on Hui's last shot.
Nice,
Petar. Are we going to have a close-up of him? He's been saved by 0.2, talking about the Serbian athlete.
Yeah,
so, in the contract of Serbia, you have to come in the top three or four.
The two Chinese.
Alexei. Okay, it's been informed on your screen there's a few technical challenges, so you won't see the graphics, so you'd have to listen more carefully, unfortunately. So at the moment, Alexei Raymond, the scores, Raymond 49.5, Hepachal 48.4. 7th and 8th go to Liu from China and Hui from China. So Stevan Pletikosic from Serbia is still in the game. However, there's a whole 3 points between him and Tomasz Bartnik in 5th place. That's going to be the key, because there's only 0.4 between Petar Gorsa. Istvan Penny is another half point up. He's 0.4 behind Filip Hepachal. However, there is a whopping 1.8 gap between him and Alexi Raymond, who consolidated. In fact, no one of the top three athletes had an amazing score, 49.5, 48.4, 50.5. So they all kept pretty much where they were.
I'm just looking and thinking, oh my God, they're so close. But like everybody, except maybe Stella, it's there.
That's what we want to see. The last rifle pistol competition. This afternoon we move outside for the men's trap, but for the rifle pistol inside here, it's the end of a very long and exciting week.
Yeah, it was long.
But to be fair, you haven't done that much. You stopped in at 6 o'clock in the morning a few mornings ago, didn't you? You had to wait quite a bit of reception.
Yeah. But usually before some big competitions, I don't sleep that well, so I actually can't wait to get up in the morning.
And I suppose in your business, taking sleeping tablets is not really an option.
No, I don't do that.
So Stefan now from Serbia, he needs to do something extraordinary and count on the others having a few problems.
No.
So we lose an athlete every single shot now. Stefan Pletikosic bows out in 6th place. But if you look at his World Cup, well, the world ranking is 13th, so to make it into the top 6 is a, he probably won't be happy, but none of you ever are. However, it's a good performance. Well, you can see the graphics are back on now, which is great. So there's a 0.9 gap between Bartnik and Gorsa at the top. It's quite a significant lead. However, Estevan Penny has suddenly started to ramp up his shooting. So he's cut the gap from, he was in third, he's cut the gap to 1.3 now. So that's going to start playing on Alexi Rayon's mind. He knows he's got the best shooter in the world chasing him.
Yeah, it's not, can be easy. But then again, you know, Alexis is really good shooter. So he's not the first time in this position, and I don't think it's his last.
Oh, Penny, you see it before I do. 9.1.
Alex and Penny has the same shot, 10.1.
10.3, so they're leapfrogging. Tomasz Bartnik, as Jamie said, in his first final, Tomasz Bartnik bows out, taking the 5th place. He's had a good season there. He came 3rd in Gabler and 8th in Munich.
Yeah, and had some really good results also. And if I'm not mistaken, he changed his rifle this season.
Don't look at me.
Yeah, maybe I will be corrected later, but I think so. Yeah.
Say, 4 athletes left in the competition. That's you on the they're on the screen.
Yeah. Well, it's boring there, so.
That was your thinking brain. That was your. I may be mistaken, but. So, Petar Gorsa, the reason we're on him
can't
is...
can't even watch.
But, well, he's from the same country as you. He scored... let's see what he's going to score. Ooh, we're 9.6. No.
This will be...
so oh, so just missed out the medal. you can see.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see, absolutely. Needs a big hug, so you need to go and sort him out in a few minutes.
I was so hoping for him.
Three athletes left. Filip Nepichal from Czech Republic is 0.6 adrift of Istvan Penny from Hungary, who's 0.9 adrift from Alexi Rimmel. So the gap is narrowing. This is the man who is producing the best shots in the last three series. The only athlete to hit 10.
He needs a strong 10.
Ooh, 9. He's going to sell his gun. Ooh, a 10.7. That helps.
That's a lifesaver. And they're only 0.7 apart.
Stevan Penny with one shot. Well, he had a dodgy shot before, so that's not a bad week's work there. Although he looks disappointed.
No, but you know, when you are next to the world record and you are the best in qualifications by far and you end up third, it's a kind of disappointment.
So far, fourth place, absolutely gutted. Third place, very disappointed. Let's see how we can move on to the top two.
So, wanna bet?
I never bet because I'm not qualified to bet. But the Czech is dreaming. Anyway, last shot. Who can handle the pressure the most? On the left, your picture is Alexi with a 0.7 lead. So anything 10.3, and he's happy.
That's the finish.
Well done. Big smile.
Wow.
But at 18, he's thinking, oh.
I heard the audience.
I think he knew already.
Yeah.
Smiles at himself.
That's
great
amazing
shooting.
That's amazing finish, really.
That's great, isn't it?
Yes. He's
giving himself a good winter.
Yeah. My work here is done. I can go home.
Well done. All the athletes, all 12 athletes. There's only 8, weren't they? Starting the whole qualification. So that's great, though, for different generations. Alexi Rinno is the gold medal winner at the 2017 rifle three possession final for the World Cup finals. Say well done all the athletes. Maybe a bit
congrats.
Of surprise, but there we are. Bronze medal for Hungary. Istvan Penny, well done. Had a junior world record in qualifications?
11.85.
Silver medal. So, Jana, thank you so much and
thank
enjoy
you.
Your pistol shooting.
Yeah, I'll try.
Find out
whose
gun is first. Thank you.
Bye.
Alexi Rinno takes the gold medal for France. So we'll have the victory ceremony in a few moments, but well done all the athletes, especially Alexi Rinno from France, who's the top man today. Thank you.